Welcome back. Celebrity-style customer service is more than just what you do or what you say. It also means giving customers a chance to make their feelings known. You need to take whatever steps are necessary to find out what your customers want, need, and care about. Here are some ideas for determining what direction to take. First, attend trade shows and industry events that are important to your customers. You'll find out what the competition is doing and what kinds of products and services customers are looking for. Keep alert for trends, then respond to them. Read industry-related trade publications, be active in trade organizations, and pay attention to what your customers are doing. Ask for feedback. Survey your current customers regularly to find out how your company is doing. Send postage-paid questionnaire cards or letters, call them by phone, or send them an email. Ask for suggestions, then immediately fix the problem areas revealed. Whatever you do, don't sit on their suggestions. Show them that you're doing something. And regularly evaluate your product or service to be sure it is still priced, packaged, and delivered correctly. Be transparent. When confronted with a truly difficult question that requires research on your part, admit it. Few things ruin your credibility faster than trying to answer a question when you are unsure of all the facts. Savvy buyers may test you with a question they know you cannot answer, or that they already have the answer to, and then they just sit quietly while you struggle to fake a positive outcome. An honest reply always enhances your integrity. Take responsibility. Tell your customer you realize there's been a mix-up, regardless whose fault it is, but you'll personally take care of it. That kind of attitude alone will heap huge amounts of gratitude and credibility upon you. Develop a customer satisfaction policy. A customer satisfaction policy is how you respond when things go wrong. Most people do not expect perfection from any business. But the degree to which perfection is critical differs according to the nature of the business. Remember, customer complaints don't interrupt your work, they're the reason for it. Mistakes happen. Things change. Unforeseen circumstances arise. But what customers don't understand is why a business will fail to take responsibility when mistakes do happen or when unfortunate things occur. Neither do they understand nor forgive when the business owner keeps silent when an unforeseen circumstance arises. There are plenty of things that you, the entrepreneur, can do to ensure good customer satisfaction. And when you're a one-person business, it's usually easier to stay on top of what your customers want. But as you add employees, whether it's one person or 100, you are adding more links to the customer satisfaction chain, and therefore creating more potential for poor service along the way. That's why creating a customer satisfaction policy and adhering to it is so important. Here are some steps you can take to ensure that your customers receive excellent celebrity-style customer service every step of the way. First, put your customer service policy in writing. These principles should come from the owner, but every employee should know what the rules are and be ready to live up to them. Establish support systems that give the employees clear instructions for gaining and maintaining service superiority. These systems will help you shine above all competitors by giving more to customers and anticipating problems, even before they arise. Develop a measurable level of superb customer service. Then reward your employees who practice it consistently. Be sure that your passion for customer service runs rampant throughout the company. Your employees should see how good service relates to your profits and to their future with the company. Be genuinely committed to providing more customer service excellence than anyone else in your industry. This commitment must be so powerful that all of your customers can sense it. Share information with people on the front lines. Meet regularly with your employees to talk about ways of improving service. Solicit ideas from them. They are the ones who are dealing with the customers most often. Act on the knowledge that customers value attention, competence, promptness, and dependability. Your customers love being treated as individuals and being referred to by name. Don't you? Think about it. It's amazing that the vast majority of unsatisfied customers will never tell you when they're unhappy. They simply quietly leave, and then they tell everyone they know not to do business with you. So when a customer does complain, don't think of it as a nuisance. Look forward to it. Think of it as a golden opportunity to change that customer's mind and retain his or her business. Even the best product or service meets with complaints or problems now and again. But how you handle these issues and provide positive results, and how you ward off complaints before they even occur, marks you as a true business professional. Keep customers updated. Even if your business is a cash and carry operation, it probably requires coordinating and scheduling numerous events. Make sure your customers are advised of the status of these events. The longer your lead time, the more important this is. The vendors that customers trust the most are those who keep them apprised of the progress of that process, whether the news is good or bad. Deliver on time. A due date that has been agreed upon is a promise that must be kept. Being close just won't get it. Monday means Monday. The first week of July means the first week in July, even though it contains a national holiday. Your clients are waiting to hear you say, "I deliver on time." The supplier who consistently does this is a rarity and will be well remembered. Make sure you provide exactly what they ordered. Don't provide something that's similar to or better than what was ordered, unless it was previously approved by the customer. Even if you believe a substitute would be in the client's best interest, that's a topic for discussion, not something you decide on your own. Make sure you complete the job as promised. Assure the customer that there will be no waiting for a final piece or a last document. Never say that you'll be finished, except for this or that or whatever. Imagine you're the one with the complaint. How would you want the situation to be handled? It's your responsibility to ensure a satisfactory outcome to the issue. Assure the customer you know what she expects and will deliver the product or service at the agreed-upon time and price. Also state that there will not be any unexpected expenses or changes required to solve the problem. Let customers vent their feelings. Encourage them to get their frustrations out into the open. Let them tell you how they really feel. Then do whatever is necessary to correct the issue. Never tell a customer, "You don't have a problem." Those are fighting words. Share your point of view as politely as you can. Take responsibility for the problem. Don't make excuses. If an employee was sick or a third-party supplier let you down, that's not your customer's concern. Immediately take action to remedy the situation. Promising a solution, then delaying it only makes matters worse. Fix it, then tell them you fixed it. Empower your frontline employees. Give them the flexibility and authority to resolve complaints. Give employees some leeway in deciding when to bend the rules. If you don't feel comfortable doing this, make sure they at least have you or another manager handle the situation promptly. Tell your customers, "I appreciate your business." This means more than a simple "thanks for your order." Genuine appreciation involves follow-up calls, offering to answer questions, making sure everything is performing satisfactorily, and ensuring that the original problem has been solved. Neglecting any of these steps conveys the impression that you were interested in them only until the sale was made. This leaves the buyer feeling deceived and used, and creates ill will and negative word-of-mouth advertising for your business. Sincerely proving that you care about your customers leads to recommendations and repeat sales. Let's talk about handling complaints. Well, as we discussed, most customers just don't complain. Statistics show that 96% of customers with complaints will not call. They will simply not buy from you again. This means that only 4% will actually register a complaint. But you should be glad when they do. In fact, you should frequently ask, "How are we doing?" This will allow you the opportunity to take care of a problem and perhaps retain the customer. When someone has a complaint, whether it's real or imagined, you may be the last to know it. And when you do find out, it may already be too late to save the customer. When a customer does complain, you can assume several things. 1. They want to continue to be your customer. 2. They are giving you an opportunity to make things right. And 3. They want to be reasonable and fair about it. You should always keep in mind that the customer may not always be right, but they are still the customer, and they should be treated accordingly. Never argue with them. You won't win. Instead, try to guide your discussion with the customer toward the solution of the problem. You just want to know how to make things right. But you may have to listen to the customer let off some steam before you can get down to the resolution of the complaint. Don't interfere. Just let them get it off their chest. Then offer a satisfactory solution to the problem. If you run a service business, remember that over 50% of that service involves educating your customers about what you do and why. And sometimes that is all that's required in correcting a perceived problem. The truth of the matter is that you can choose how you are going to react to a complaint. You can choose to be indifferent to the complaint, or you can choose to let the incident upset you and ruin your day. The professional's choice is obvious. Here's a plan that can help you handle complaints very successfully. First, listen. Listen to the customer without interrupting. Don't make excuses or be defensive. Make sure that you understand what they are saying and ask questions to clarify the situation. Take notes if you need to. Evaluate. Pause a few minutes after they have stated their case to evaluate and develop a plan that will satisfy them. Apologize. Make an apology if it's appropriate. It usually is. Be careful not to acknowledge responsibility, especially if the complaint involves a damage claim or an injury. That's for your insurance company to determine. But you can still be sympathetic. If nothing else, apologize for the fact that they may have been inconvenienced by the incident. Empathize. Make empathetic statements. Empathy is sincerely and honestly caring about someone else's dilemma. Examples can be, "I can understand why this has upset you so much. I don't blame you for thinking that we might have stained your carpet. But the fact of the matter is..." Another example would be, "I certainly agree with your concern. I'm also a parent, and I would have been just as concerned as you. But the fact of the matter is..." And last, take action. Do something. Don't delay. That will only make matters worse. If someone else will be handling the complaint, be sure to write down the details. Then ensure the problem is handled. Call your customer after the problem has been resolved to see that they are happy. Sometimes a formal letter from management may be in order. How do you handle the irate customer? Well, most customers will be reasonable. But once in a while, in spite of all that you do, you will encounter an unhappy customer who has become irate. Unhappy customers can ruin your day if you let them. They will tell a dozen or more people, they won't refer new customers, and they may even try to sue you if they can't get satisfaction any other way. In the beginning, they may be totally unreasonable, but it's your job to handle them, get them calmed down, and work out a fair solution of the problem. The following strategy will usually work, but it will require self-discipline and patience. Remember, you have nothing to gain by trying to get even or by telling the customer off. Choose to be calm. There is practically no difference in the steps to be taken between handling a standard complaint and trying to defuse a sticky, caustic situation with an irate customer. Just start out with confidence that you can solve the problem to their satisfaction and always remember to wear a smile. First, listen. Listen carefully to the customer. Ask any questions you need to clarify the problem. Be caring and express your concern. Stay cool. Don't take irate remarks personally. Remember, you have nothing to gain by returning aggression for aggression. Empathize. Express empathy and apologize if there has been a mistake, even if it's only perceived. Use statements like, "I appreciate your problem," or, "I know, I have felt that way myself." When you apologize, do it in the name of your company. Something like, "I want you to know that this is not a standard practice for our company, and I apologize for this apparent mistake. We never intend to treat our valued customers this way." Understand the problem. Focus on the problem and not on who is at fault. Deal only with the facts. Put yourself in the customer's shoes. Offer a solution. Offer a solution or find someone who can solve the problem. Do not delay this action. Then thank the customer. Thank the customer for bringing the problem to your attention. Remember, even though complaints are no fun, especially from irate customers, they do tell you how you and your business can improve. Sometimes you'll need to know how to say no without really saying no. Now, everyone dislikes the word no. We all heard it all the time as a child and developed a strong dislike for it. No is especially onerous when you are the one paying the bill. Another phrase that is just as distasteful is, "It's company policy." As in every confrontation with a customer, listen to them and try to understand the situation. Try to understand their feelings and then tell them that you do understand. Ensure that you do understand the problem, but decline with a reason. An example might be, "We would like to be able to do what you want, but this would be difficult because..." If it truly is company policy, explain the reason for the policy without calling it a company policy. Then suggest alternatives such as, "Why don't we do this instead?" You need to find ways of going above and beyond the call of duty. You know, these days, simply providing adequate customer service is just not enough. You need to go above and beyond the call of duty to provide celebrity-style customer service that truly stands out. How do you do this? Begin by thinking about your own experiences as a customer. What have you liked and disliked in certain buying situations? Recall the times that you were delighted by extra efforts taken to accommodate your needs, or outraged by rudeness or negligence. This will give you greater insight and a better appreciation into what makes for extraordinary customer service. To put yourself in a customer's shoes, try visiting or calling a wide range of businesses your customers are likely to frequent. This could include your direct competitors, as well as companies that sell related products and services. Observe how customers are treated, in addition to the kinds of services that seem to be important to them. Then adapt your business accordingly. Going above and beyond is especially important when a customer has complained or if there is a problem with a purchase. Suppose an order is delayed. What can you do? Well, first, call the customer personally. Provide updates on the status of the order and expected arrival time. Hand deliver the merchandise when it does arrive. It doesn't matter how far you have to travel or how long it takes. Take 20 to 30% off the order. Now that's a small price to pay to ward off bad publicity. And then send a note apologizing for the delay. Tuck it inside a gift basket full of goodies to them. These are all ways of showing the customer you're on his or her side. But going above and beyond doesn't always mean offering deep discounts or giving away products. With a little ingenuity and effort, you can show customers they are important at any time. Suppose you've just received the newest samples and colors for your home furnishings line. Why not invite your best customers to a private showing, complete with music, appetizers, and a coupon good for a free hour of personal consultation. Emergency orders and last-minute changes should be accommodated when possible, especially for important occasions such as a wedding or a big trade show. Customers remember these events, and they will remember your flexibility and prompt response to their needs, too. Customer loyalty is hard to win and very easy to lose. But by going above and beyond with your customer service, you'll soon see your sales going above and beyond those of your competitors. When customers are happy with your service, ask them for a testimonial letter. Obtain permission to use quotes from the letter in your print ads and brochures. Also ask if you can give their phone number to certain qualified prospects so they can get a solid recommendation about your business firsthand. Our world is vast, but technology is bringing us closer together. Happy customers are the result of targeted follow-up marketing. The key to unlocking another layer of your growth potential is found in providing celebrity-style customer service both before and after the sale. So, if you want to make your business really stand out, and if you want to create lasting growth, you need to set in motion systems that nurture the customer. Extend your vision past the actual data. People are much more than a number, and selling is about much more than statistics. Truly, put yourself in their shoes, not as yourself, but as them. Look at their life, their job, their community, even their newspaper, and weave your celebrity-style customer service message around it.